Hello, I am Dr. Prashant Kumar. Today I am going to briefly discuss on the cardiovascular effects of mechanical ventilation. As we know that heart and lung both are contained in the thoracic cavity, so each organ has its effect on the other organ. This is a schematic representation of the thoracic cavity where PAW is showing pressure of the airway. This is PALV, alveolar pressure. PPL, pleural pressure. PEX is extramural pressure. PIN is intramural pressure. PTM is intramural pressure minus extramural pressure. And systolic pressure is roughly equal to P intramural pressure plus extramural pressure. So this is a cross-sectional representation of the heart and lung. And this picture is showing how closely the vessels and the heart and the lung are interrelated. So if this is contained in one cavity, the pressure rises in each organ is going to affect the other organ. So hemodynamic effects of the changes in the intrathoracic pressure. This side is showing venous return. This is the thoracic pressure and this is the LV ejection. So when there is rise in thoracic pressure, the increase in the intrathoracic pressure decreases the pressure gradients for venous return and the left ventricular ejection. And when the intrathoracic pressure decreases, the increase in the pressure gradient for the venous return and the LV ejection. So there are two predominant cardiovascular effects of the spontaneous respiration: a rise in LV afterload and a rise in RV preload. Factors that will potentially accentuate the blood pressure fluctuation during spontaneous breathing include a fall in preload, such as hypovolemia and vasodilation, and a rise in the left ventricular afterload as a result of increased inspiratory effort, for example, bronchospasm or a spontaneous breathing through endotracheal tube. So, inspiration, positive pressure. Comparing with a spontaneous, air is blown into the lungs, which compresses the pleural cavity and the pulmonary vessels. So this is the pictorial representation of the ventilator breaths inspiration animation. So what happens when the air is blown into the lungs? This goes in, it increases the lung pressure and air moves down the pressure gradient to fill the lungs. This is the, then the lung expands, which increases the intrapleural pressure. Ventilator breath expiration animation, similar to spontaneous, is passive. The ventilator stops blowing air. The pressure gradient alveolus to trachea. Air moves out of the lung like this and the lung collapses, lung volume decreases. So the expiration is passive and similar in both the positive pressure ventilation and the spontaneous pressure. So the details, inspiration, pressure or volume. When we push air, a gas at set pressure, pressure or a set volume, volume. So this is the details of the pressure volume curve and the volume control ventilation. In the pressure control, the pressure rises and plateaus. In the volume control, it rises slowly and plateaus. But the expiration part of both these two types of basic ventilation is similar. So this is the details of expiration. So cardiovascular effects of mechanical ventilation. What happens? The compresses on the pulmonary vessels, reduced RV outflow and reduced LV inflow. So this is the representation. What happens? This is the alveolar unit and this is the this is the alveolar unit and the blood is flowing in the capillaries from the right side of the heart to the left side. So when this alveolus expands, this compresses and this capillaries before the heart dilates and there is less return of the blood to the left side of the heart. So similar here. What happens when there is increase in the intrathoracic pressure? Then the cardiac output decreases due to reduced return of the blood to the left side of the heart. So the cardiovascular effects: compresses on the pulmonary vessels, reduce LV inflow, decrease in the cardiac output stroke volume, blood pressure is equal to cardiac output multiplied by resistance, and decrease in the blood pressure. And there are neurohumoral effects also: reduced RV outflow backtracked to the body, head, there is increase in the intracranial pressure, and others increase in the venous pressure. Details: cardiovascular effects, compresses on the pulmonary vessels, inspiration plus expiration, more pressure, increase in the effects on the cardiovascular. If low blood volume, vessels are more compressible and increase in effects. Details on the compliance changes: if you push in a gas at a set pressure, pressure control ventilation, tidal volume is directly proportional to compliance. So the compliance is equal to tidal volume divided by delta pressure, and if compliance, distensibility, stretchiness changes, tidal volume will change. Whereas in volume control ventilation, the pressure is inversely proportional to compliance, and if the compliance, distensibility, stretchability changes, the airway pressure will change. So the details of the compliance changes: normal ventilating lungs, abnormal ventilating, suppose there is a left pneumothorax, then whatever tidal volume is pushed in, it will go to one side of the lung, it will increase the pressure more than the other side, and this will have a untoward and worsened effect on the pressure of the endothoracic cavity. Like this patient having a pneumothorax, and if the patient is ventilated, this will have more cardiovascular effects than the other. This is the CT of the patient having pneumothorax. And effects of PEEP, what effects of the PEEP there? PEEP is also a pressure which increases the intrathoracic pressure, and the compliance is equal to delta tidal volume divided by pressure. So what happens when the energy is needed to open the damage during the open closing abnormal forces? So over distended alveoli, when this PV loop reaches here, there is over distended alveoli, and in when we apply PEEP, the working area of the PV loop is at the above level. So then there is more effect on the intrathoracic pressure, and the cardiovascular effects will be also more compared to the patient having a normal or less PEEP, like 5. So the PEEP starts inspiration from a higher pressure here, higher pressure, and although its effects on the oxygenation and alveolar recruitment may be different, but the cardiovascular effects are enhanced. On the other hand, if we see the functional residual capacity portion, the healthy lungs have a closing capacity which is lower than the FRC. In diseased lung, the reverse happens, and the patient has higher closing capacity than the FRC. So regional ventilation, PEEP. This is also very important to understand, because what happens when there is a healthy lung, then the upper portion of the lung in the standing, it is the apical portion, which is more having distended than the lower, which is collapsed. In normal healthy lung, then the apical portion is having more aeration than the lower bases, and when the patient is supine and patient is mechanically ventilated, these all the effects are ventral to dorsal. So the dorsal portion of the lung are more collapsed at a lactatic than the ventral portion, and these distension are then redistributed. This is another representation how the healthy and diseased lung has an effect of PEEP. So this is showing the normal lung, low tidal volume, and normal PEEP. So this is the mid portion, which is having normal ventilation perfusion ratio, and the lower portion, which is collapsed. In the normal lung, high tidal volume, PEEP is 5. Again, when the patient with ALI, is ventilated with high tidal volume with high PEEP, then there is over distension of the ventral portion of the lung. There is some recruitment of the lung in the mid portion, and the basal or some collapsed. So practically it is ventilation, which route, intubation versus others, correct placement, ventilator settings, spontaneous versus control, pressure versus volume, PEEP, how much oxygen to give, monitoring adequacy of ventilation, ventilation drugs to make it possible, ventilation drug side effects, other issues.